Welcome to our lesson number 8. We continue with the examples on different FRPs and the calculations thereof. So today we are going to look at a calculation concerning heat of neutralization. So we have an example here. When 50 centimeter cubic of 2 molar hydrochloric acid was mixed with 50 centimeter cubic of sodium hydroxide. So this should also be same concentration, same volume. 2 molar sodium hydroxide solution, a temperature rise of 13.0 degrees Celsius was realized. From this information, determine the molar heat of neutralization and write some chemical equation for the reaction. So, to calculate the molar enthalpy of neutralization, first we calculate that before we incorporate 1 mole of. In this case, so we start from here. So, we will calculate first the molar heat, which would be, the heat of neutralization, which will be determined by MC delta T. And here for neutralization, the mass of solution, it will be the mass of acid plus that of base. So in this case, to get the volume of the solution, in other words, so the mass will be the sum of the two. In this case, so we take the volume of the solution to be the sum of the two. So the volume of the solution, so the solution contains the acid and the base, so it will be, we take the volume of acid plus volume of the base. So in this case, the volume of the acid is 50, volume of the base is 50, and that gives us 100 centimeter cubic. And here the assumption is that we assume the density, of the solution to be the same as that of water, which will be 1 gram per centimeter cubic. So from there, now we can calculate the mass of the solution. So mass of solution will be density times volume. So density 1 gram per centimeter cubic times volume to be 100 centimeter cubic. So centimeter cubic cancels per centimeter cubic, and that gives us 100 grams of the solution. Now note this, the mass is in grams, and look at the specific heat capacity. The specific heat capacity is given in grams. When given like this, it is not a must to convert the mass into kilograms, because here the specific capacity is in grams, so we can just work with the grams, and then the answer will be in joules. So now we insert the values to this formula. So delta H is going to be the mass, which is 100 grams, multiplied by the specific heat capacity given as 4.2 joules per gram per Kelvin, multiplied by the temperature change it rose by. So that is the change that I illustrated in the other example. The change, whether in degree Celsius or in Kelvin, it will be the same. So the change will be 13 Kelvin. So from here you cancel out the units. So per Kelvin cancel with Kelvin. Grams cancel with the per gram. So that means when we calculate, our answer is going to be in joules and not kilojoules. If we want it in kilojoules, then now we divide by 1,000. So if we work out, so we're going to have 100 times 4.2 13. So this would give us 5460 joules. If you divide this by 1000, this would be equivalent to 5.4 kilo joules, because we had said in the first lesson that 1000 joules equals to 1 kilo joule. So then you can express that in kilo joules. So that would be the heat change. Then the question was the molar to calculate now then for one mole. So we have to find how many moles of the acid reacting. By definition, heat of neutralization is the heat change that occurs when the hydrogen ions in the acid are completely neutralized, by the base or the alkali solution. So we therefore tell you that the base that was used completely neutralized the acid. So we can get the moles of the acid. Since we have volume and we have molarity, we can determine the number of moles of the acid. Moles of acid will be determined as molarity times volume, then divided by 1000. So the molarity is 2, volume is 50, divided by 1000. So this would give us 0.1 moles. So these are the moles of the acid. So to calculate the molar heat, then we will say if 0.1 moles gives out this amount of heat energy, 5.4 kilojoules. 5.4 kilojoules. One mole will divide how much? Let's say x cross multiply. So x will be 1 times 5.4 divided by 0.1. That will give us 54. So you left a 6 there. So 6 there. So it will be 54.6 kilojoules. So this time I'm saying per mole because it is for one mole. And since there was a rise in temperature, it means the reaction was exothermic. So for molar heat, you have to indicate whether it was endothermic or exothermic. So you put a minus sign there to indicate that the reaction was exothermic. Then you are also asked to write the thermochemical equation for this reaction. So the thermochemical equation for the reaction will be, so the reaction between hydrochloric acid plus sodium hydroxide solution. So this will give salt and water, sodium chloride is the salt and water. Then for it to be a thermochemical, so we add the molar heat change for one mole and getting 54.6 kilo joules per mole. So that becomes the thermochemical equation for the reaction.
Okay, consider this NB. When a strong acid is neutralized by a weak acid, the molar enthalpy of neutralization is slightly less than is less. For example, the molar enthalpy of neutralization of hydrochloric acid by aqueous ammonia is negative 52.2 kilojoules compared to the value that we have had for hydrochloric acid, which is a bit higher. So if you compare this value here, 54.6, if you compare